2022 Village Board meeting to order. Mr. White, will you lead us in the pledge?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Roll call, please, Allison.
Trustee White.
Here.
Trustee Shomas.
Here.
Trustee Lindy.
Here.
Trustee Aaron. Trustee Bonnie?
Here.
President Conan?
Here.
Trustee Walter?
Okay, we do have a quorum. Nothing under public hearings this evening. Appointments and presentation. We do have four police commissioners on here. What are we doing?
It was placed on here if needed. There was supposed to be a police commission meeting tomorrow night, and they were looking to appoint a new member. The chief was talking about it. The board was comfortable with that, but based on the agenda for the meeting, they actually canceled that meeting, so there's no need to make an appointment tonight.
Okay. So we'll forego that. Airport report, we do not have Mr. Wolf here this evening. Any public comments at this time on items scheduled for action under the consent agenda? We have A, approval of the minutes of the October 4th, 2022 Village Board meeting, B, approval of the voucher, C, approval of the treasurer's report. Under general business, we have A, a resolution amending fees and the number of liquor licenses per liquor class for the 22-23 licensing year, B, approval awarding a liquor license to Burnt Barrel Social, C, a resolution authorizing an intergovernmental agreement with Sugar Grove Park District, Sugar Grove Township for the Blackberry Creek Pedestrian Bike Bridge Project for maintenance. D, a resolution authorizing execution of an agreement with the Aurora Sign Company for the replacement of the Public Works Monument sign. Any public comments at this time for any of those items scheduled for action? Okay, hearing none. We will close that portion. Can I get a motion to approve the consent agenda as previously stated? Thank you. Oh, I'm sorry, I do. It's fall and the weather. Would anybody like to remove an item from the consent agenda? I'm sorry. Hearing none, can I get that motion? Thank you.
Second.
I have a second. First on Trustee White, second on Trustee Shomas. Roll call, please. Allison.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Shomas?
Aye.
Trustee Bonnie?
Aye.
Trustee Lindy?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Up next, general business, a resolution amending fees and the number of liquor licenses per liquor class. Allison?
Yes, so the proprietors of Burnt Barrel Social have approached us for a liquor license class E restaurant. They are mostly done with their application. There were a couple of things we were waiting to get clarified, but we wanted to go ahead and have the license approved and also approve the liquor license number and the fee so that when they do wrap it up, we wouldn't have to wait another 2 weeks to get it. So the rate is prorated. I think it's $770. It starts from December 1st, so that was when they anticipated being open.
Okay. Any board members have any questions or discussion?
So you said there were a couple of items that were still left for them to complete on it. So we would approve pending the completion of
Adding steps.
Yes. So and we've done that in the past. It's just there's just a few pieces bigger that we need to very good and well.
Okay. Any other discussion? Hearing none, can I get a motion to approve the resolution amending fees and the number of liquor licenses per liquor class for the 22-23 licensing year?
Second.
Thank you. I first up, Trustee White. Oh, excuse me. Amending to say per staff review.
Isn't that just the issuance of the license?
I think there's
certain.
Yes,
first staff. Sorry. That's only a staff review on item B, the issuance of board or bureau.
Yes.
So.
Oh, it's not on A?
Yes, it's A here.
Okay. Fine. Motion's good. Thank you. Roll call, please, Allison.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Shomas?
Aye.
Trustee Lundy?
Aye.
Trustee Bonnie?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Okay. So next we have approval awarding a liquor license to Burke Herald Social.
So moved, subject to staff review.
Thank you.
Second.
Thank you. Roll call, please.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Shomas?
Aye.
Trustee Bonnie?
Aye.
Trustee Lynn?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Up next, we have a resolution offering an intergovernmental agreement with Sherbrooke Proctors to the Sherbrooke Township for the Blackberry Creek Pedestrian Bike Bridge. Tony?
This is for the maintenance of the project. I know we're still working on engineering, but IDOT wants all the agreements in place before we move off forward so that it's all clear and who's maintaining and going forward. So that's what this agreement is with the three governmental bodies that are going to maintain the bridge. And it starts once the bridge is constructed.
Thank you. Any discussion? No? Trustee Shomas, you look like you might have a question.
The cost share. Can you explain what's going on in component C? First page there. Not, I know it's buried within the resolution. I don't know where it was. There's some in the sentence that doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Cumulative amounts in excess of $2,000 per party per maintenance project or $6,000 per party per calendar year shall require the consent of at least two. Yeah, what's that saving?
It's each party.
Per project, so it's $2,000 a year upon, we went through this, so, or I did. $2,000, and tell me if I'm wrong in your interpretation of it. It's $2,000 once construction is started. Everybody's going to pay $2,000. The park district will.
That's going to the park district.
Goes to the park district.
Cut the grass and do the other stuff.
Right. Any project that is larger than those dollars that they've put in there, they're authorizing up to $6,000 per entity. So that would be six for the village a year annually. Anything after that $6,000 comes back in front of the board.
Two of the three. So if the village says no, but the other two say yes, the village would be committed with whatever the majority of the IGA entities say. And we had discussed, you know, what that might mean, depending on the entity, it might mean going back before the respective boards. It might be something that could be done at another one's staff level. It would depend on the nature of what.
So each of the groups are putting $6,000 a year into a.
If necessary. $2,000 to start.
Okay.
Once construction gets underway.
All right.
Absolutely.
But there is a fee to build up an escrow 20 years from now when it comes time to replace.
Not initially, but it's something that. One of the ongoing items will be a periodic bridge inspection.
Yeah.
And at some point in time, if that inspection says, hey, you ought to plan X amount of years for some significant expense,
okay,
then we would look at establishing something. Because right now, it's expected to be for 20 years, touch on pains.
Right.
You know, it's.
And obviously, we're just starting phase two engineering, so.
Yeah. But to your point, I agree with what you're saying. I talked to Matt about that too. It could be something simple as we go through the budget process that he's allocating $1,000 a year on our end,
right,
just to build our own site up.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
Yeah. Even if it's 20 years from now, we want to be prepared for it, not have to take it away from Brad's fancy new truck. You know?
That's right.
It's like, I'll be gone. So we'll be Brad's truck. Okay. Oh my gosh. All right. Can I get that motion as previously stated then?
As stated.
Can I get a second?
Second.
I have a first out of Trustee Shomas and a second out of Trustee Lundy. Roll call, please.
Trustee Shomas?
Aye.
Trustee Lundy?
Aye.
Trustee Bonnie?
Aye.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Harris?
Aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Up next, we have a resolution authorizing the execution of an agreement with Aurora Sign Company for the replacement of the Public Works Monument sign. After further discussion with staff, we've decided to postpone this item to come up with some better options than what was presented to the board this evening, some less expensive options. So can I get a motion to approve motion to postpone item D, the resolution, indefinitely?
Yes, second.
Thank you. Second? Second?
Second.
Thank you, Heidi. Can I have a first of trustee Shonis and second of trustee Lundy? Roll call, please, Allison.
Trustee Shonis?
Aye.
Trustee Lundy?
Aye.
Trustee Heron?
Aye.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Vaughn?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passes. Up next, we have public comment. Any public comments at this time? Or anything under the sun?
5-1 in the top lane.
Good to know.
Good to know. Yankees are winning.
Are they?
Actually, that part's helpful.
Random score. They were up.
Where
they
playing?
What's that?
They're playing the Jets.
You know
what? See, I got a better record than theirs. That's bad.
All right, no public comments at this time. We will close that portion.
No,
yeah, well, no additional public comments.
Okay. 3 minutes are up.
Yeah, I guess you could talk about that for 3 minutes. Up next, discussion, design engineering service agreement for the U.S. 30 Municipal Drive pedestrian crossing. Tony.
In preparing for this project, we just wanted to bring it to the board for discussion, for $16,000 for the phase one engineering, design engineering for the crossing. We would bring it back on the consent agenda once we had been informed that the funds were secured. So we just wanted to have it ready as it's set to go so that we can get started on it. Fortunately, we learned today that it's still in a holding pattern from our representative future representative hasn't received word that this program has been funded yet. So if there's any questions or any discussion, otherwise we'll bring it back on the program.
Yeah, the idea was to have you look at it tonight if you had any questions, get an answer in the meantime that way. Hopefully sooner than rather than later we get authorization to proceed and then we can put it on a consent agenda at a future meeting. We think it's all clean and we don't anticipate questions, but we, if you do have them, we'd like to deal with them now rather than lose a couple of weeks in the future.
Yeah, we originally thought it was going to be funded in October.
And,
and
just so the
board be ready. Still October.
Yeah, just so the board knows too, I did ask staff and Tony specifically about, we had budgeted about $160,000 for this crossing. The grant that has been allocated to us is $125,000. So I thought, well, you know, if we're going to spend $160,000, let's go ahead with this engineering right now. And Tony said that they anticipate the cost last adjusted maybe was around $120,000. Something
I
like that construction cost.
Yeah, in other words, anything we would start or do now not be refundable.
Right.
Not, and if we did put it out when it was ready to be constructed, if it really was $125,000 or less for construction, then you couldn't cover the $16,000 with the grant, even if there was room to cover it. So
now we wait, because I think the construction cost was maybe around $120,000.
And
you can't
right.
remember.
I mean,
it was a lot less than what we had actually budgeted. So
correct.
I think it's too close to actually go out and pay for the engineering at this point, which is why we want to discuss it and then bring it back for consent when they're ready. Yes, please.
My biggest concern here, we've ridden our bikes across here many times, is that this light gets blown a lot compared to. My biggest concern is what are we doing in these plans to warn cars that there's a prepared to stop, you know, stuff like that. I don't want to just have a light with a go. I think there needs to be something on the highway side of it that's going to give us the best opportunity to warn cars to stop so that we don't have somebody trusting the walk light and getting plastered.
Great. Well, since since it is an IDOT road, we have to follow IDOT specs. And with that being said, this is phase one, the design engineering. So that's where that would be looked at, because all we had was a preliminary look at the intersection. So that would be something that to follow up with as we finish the and start the phase one.
Okay. That's my big concern, because I'll vote no if I don't think it's going to be safe.
Well, we want.
I know. We agree on it.
And we are limited by what IDOT will let us. You know, if we put flashing lights for the bad, if we're going to be limited by what
we might be able to do stuff like that.
I understand the concern, but I also go back with it's a horrific situation today. So any improvement is better than no improvement, even though I understand your concern. I mean, you can have somebody blow a light at 47 and there's a crosswalk there. I mean, this exists in other
sites. Just comparatively. Yeah. It's a tough intersection.
It is a tough intersection. I mean, we have a lot of those, unfortunately, in Sugar Grove just because of the nature of the state roads that come through there.
I said I could be heard at any meeting I wanted.
Is that
what
you said?
I did. Yeah, I asked him. He said,
what? He's
not kidding. All right. So are we of any other discussion by the board, or is this good for staff to bring back when it's ready? Good? Yeah. Okay. Thank you. The 2023 village meeting schedule. Allison.
So the schedule as presented is how it is outlined in, village code, the first and third meeting, there are Tuesdays of each month, the four board meetings, and then the third Wednesday of each month for planning commission and for board of police commissioners, and every 3 months for on Friday, the ADM for Police Pension Board. The only difference is on the 4th of July, which falls on a Tuesday this year. In the past, those meetings that have fallen actually on a holiday have been canceled. So we went ahead and did that. The last one was in 2017 for the 4th of July. The West Monitor is out.
This one is out too. There's nothing to the north.
You are the west. I'm the north. I was operational.
Hey, Walter.
It was actually the east and the west that were out.
All third Wednesday, the last one first. Whereas, we seem to have a lot of, when I was on the plane, we had a lot of special meetings, and we seem to be. Would the second one be better? Or?
No, the reason
why they're shaking is that.
No, the reason for the special meetings is that we're trying to expedite some applications.
So the only thing I wanted to say about the schedule, and whether anybody wants to hear anyone, so let's talk about next November, the 21st. It's the Tuesday before Thanksgiving. I'm always out of town. I travel that week. You travel that week. Heidi,
do
you
have
the destination
place?
You're the destination. Anyone else have an issue with that?
Next year's our Michigan. So you're gone. So next year.
So Allison, just as a point of reference before we actually have to approve this, is maybe we consider a different meeting than the 21st, just if you already know. So that was one date. Based on Kaneland schools this year, the kids are on vacation the first week. First meeting in January on the 3rd. They're actually off that full week, so we'll be out of town. I don't know if anybody else will be out of town. Okay. You'll be out of town, that's two.
January potentially is easy because there's five twos in the city. Yeah. Let's go second and fourth if you want to do it typically.
I don't want to miss everybody else's schedule if they can also function without me, but.
Well, can we still get a quorum on the 4th with
That'd be the third.
The third. You guys meeting on?
The other thing I'll just point out is that, you know, with that holiday schedule, I don't know how much of an agenda. I mean, even putting that together with the staff and everybody going, okay, between Christmas and New Year's, you might come in for a meeting that's like, hey, how are you doing?
Happy New Year.
We've got the vouchers that you don't even have to meet to approve.
Then all of a sudden, mid-February, you're going to slam us with a five-hour meeting.
My suggestion, not knowing what any of your schedules are, would be January, look at either cancel the third or look at the 10th and 24th.
Well, we usually start what budget in February? First meeting in February, or we start in January? He's not here to ask.
I don't think in January.
So. Okay.
As I said, probably not good to start on the third anyhow with what we just said.
Right.
So, the budget.
Yeah.
I mean, three people are gone. It's like,
so we pass the third, and then we add to the November 21st meeting?
The 21st. And so.
And if we have to have a special meeting, we'll have a special meeting?
Yeah. I mean, like I said, I think we more than made up for last year.
A few years worth.
Yeah, we do. So, schedule them as needed. And everybody will do their best to accommodate.
I know it's just the way it always works out, but like I said, the township, the school districts, the fire districts, they all only meet once a month. Municipalities and cities meet twice a month. The Kane County Board, I mean.
No idea.
I think that we're not hurting anything by skipping.
All right, I would move to approve the calendar with January 3rd strictly and November 21st strictly.
It's discussion.
It's discussion?
It's discussion.
All right, fine.
She hears you. You're heard.
You're heard.
I get to say stuff. Brent says I get to say stuff.
I only have one other day, which would be August 1st. It's dead week for Cleveland School District. A lot of families travel that week. I don't know if anybody else is traveling that week. Your kids play sports, you have to be back the following, but that is your week off. Summer.
Cancel the
budget. there's 5 weeks.
Just cancel my entire year. Just have a special meeting.
I'm normally gone on the first.
Okay, so let's strike that one too. So there's 3 days that we're totally striking, and then.
Please switch to 1 week in a month.
No, we're gonna have a lot of stuff. We're gonna have a lot of stuff coming in. One meeting a month isn't gonna do it.
Please, two meetings a month sometimes run long.
Listen, this is you're slowing it down.
I know.
Pick a lane. You're canceling all the meetings.
Exactly.
Pick a lane. Tony wants one meeting like 3 days. Twice a week before the spring ball.
All right, so those are the three dates that have issue. But this year Thanksgiving week is not an issue, but next year it is.
So we'll bring it back on consent, canceling the first meeting of January, August, and the second meeting in November?
Yep.
Okay.
Thank you. Anybody else have any other issues besides me? That's crazy. At least I won't feel like I'm missing now, so that's good. We'll talk about that later. Amending board meeting rules and procedures for vote attendance. He's gonna be on a business trip.
Oh, okay. As a teacher? At business trips?
Yes.
Training.
All right. Is this Allison as well? Yes.
Yes. So this is to discuss amending the board meeting rules and procedures for remote attendance. COVID gave us a wonderful opportunity to test and retest and improve sort of our remote meeting participation and technology. So there are three reasons that board members can miss, and those are set by state statute. You can't really change them, but they do not limit how many board members can participate remotely, except that you have to have a quorum. And looking back at the minutes, when this was discussed before, it was set at two because they just didn't think at that time you could understand people or keep track on a conference call. But with the video, we thought we could, and with the microphones, just remember everyone right up in it. And then the other consideration was, do you want to have remote participation for a closed session? Again, at the time, they didn't think that would be appropriate because of the limited for the conference phone and who was there. So these are just considerations that we are bringing forward for you to discuss at this time based on our new experience.
We still need a physical quorum.
Yes, you still need four. So you will have to agree.
Yeah. Okay. So I don't personally have a problem with three if three people were traveling under the excusable reasons. But I do still have an issue with closed session. And I think if we know that we're gonna have somebody who's absent, that usually we know when we need to go into closed session, that we would arrange that based on participation in person. But I think, not that anybody's devious, but I just think that you don't know who's on the other end of a recording for something that's super sensitive.
Can we mandate that the cameras are on then for a video call? I mean, if necessary.
We've had issues with that in meetings before too, where other people have popped on.
Yeah.
And I agree.
I agree.
Not knowing how sensitive the topic is, I would agree with that.
Okay.
It's just safer for everyone involved, honestly.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
So consent, yes to increasing to three remote, no additional closed session.
Correct. Okay. Thank you all. Staff reports, Brian.
The only thing I will add is I did attend the annual municipal meeting out in Cleveland, and I forwarded to the board their enrollment numbers. They talked about their capital plan, got updates from Elburn and Maple Park and Canesville, and they talked a little bit about the school district's possible referendum, but that wasn't really the subject of the meeting. But the I don't know, I think it's cool, the surprise of the meeting was that somehow they got off of alphabetical order for homecoming parade. So they are planning in Sugar Grove next year.
Next year?
Yes. So for those of you that were here last time, I thought it was cool and fun. I mean, maybe because you know, as I get older, seeing high school kids all excited about something, and they decorated the golf carts and everything in the back. It was fun. So there's no date yet. I think they wait until the football schedule comes out. I won't confirm or deny the rumor. They look to see who the opponent is to try to guarantee a win. But it will be here. So obviously, with the move of admin and finance to the other building and this being entirely police, I don't know if this would still be the appropriate place for that staging or the other building or possibly the library, but we'll figure that out. So.
Okay.
So once we get the date, we'll make sure you're in town.
That's terrible. I travel for softball a lot. There are certain vacations that I try to go on.
She's coming back to the
He's going to be your dad. Oh, Fred, I didn't remember reading that in your staff report.
No, that wasn't in my staff report.
No, the zing. Oh. Anybody have any questions?
Yeah, the discussion with Senator Durbin.
So he was Metro West. I'm not sure how it happened, but they had a meeting with him, and it was held in Aurora. It was only Metro West members that were invited. Actually, it was a pretty small crowd, so it was kind of nice because it was a small enough group that everybody present was able to, you know, have some time to talk about what's going on in their community, which, as you can imagine, was basically, hey, here's what's going on that federal dollars would really help with. And, you know, so you had from the high end, you had Montgomery was the one who took the lead for their group on Lake Michigan water. And, you know, and that's, maybe Michelle knows, $150 or $200 million or something proposed projects. So they were putting the pitch in for that. And then the Oswego administrator spoke before I did, and he was talking about their hopeful metro expansion. How their latest estimate is a $400 million-plus project. So the senator was, you know, he did congratulate them on their boldness and being afraid to address it a lot. But it was nice because I went next and I said, well, compared to that, I mean, heck, you know, 40, 14, 4.
We'll take anything.
Gave me the opportunity to talk about primarily the 8847 interchange and the needs up there. And of course, he didn't make any commitment to anybody, but that's just one of those processes where you try to get their ear, get them familiar with it, do follow up. And the other thing is, it was kind of interesting because early on, somebody made the comment about, we won't use that bad word earmark. And the senator actually said, because I have no problem with that word whatsoever. He goes, I've been doing this for however many years. And he said that, we used to do earmarks all the time. He goes, I stand by every one I ever gave and really never got any criticism because they're all legitimate public need projects. So he was not afraid to call them that. And he said that he hopes that they continue. And I did get the contact information for the gentleman's title, but to follow up, and just sent him an email today. We'll see what kind of response he gets. So it was nice. It's always fun to meet people you see on TV and have a senator from our state that's very high up.
Correct.
It's also potentially beneficial. So we'll see.
Yes.
We'll try to maintain the contact and see where it takes us.
Thank you. Michael?
Me? I'm going to start with me.
No, sorry. Oh. Michael, pass.
I'm not ready.
Two things. We had the groundbreaking ceremony yesterday for the next phase of Sugar Grove Center. And it went very well, a little chilly out. And got a chance to meet the developer and members of his team, as well as those that represented some of the tenants. So it was very nice. Thank you for everyone that was there. And we're going to continue to hopefully have more groundbreaking people can attend. And of course, we'll be helping with grand openings for Barrel in the next month. So thank you. On Thursday, I will be attending the International Council of Shopping Center Chicago show, which is down at Navy Pier. And they're on the list to have a booth at the 23 show. It's a chance to make contacts, renew some old contacts with retailers, restaurateurs, brokers, and developers.
Excellent. I really thought we were going to dig something with those shovels. I didn't know it was just a prop. But I was like, didn't you think we were actually going to dig?
Yeah.
I guess they didn't want the shovels to get dirty.
That I'm opposed to actually digging because someone said they got to clean the shovels. So, I got a feeling that would have to be me, so.
Good to know.
Can we hire Melissa?
I don't delegate to things that I don't want to do.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Good response.
Yeah. Anyone have any questions for Michael?
Do you know when that would be complete?
They're hoping that all the tenants will be in and ready to open in May. They're hoping to time it so there can be a grand opening for the whole center together.
I actually thought he said before that, but May's probably more realistic.
The build-outs will be ready earlier this spring.
They will be. They've got to kind of turn the keys over to Cold Stone and so forth. And a lot's going to depend on the weather this winter. So if you have a mild winter, then they can get more done, and that kind of people.
Okay.
They've got two tenants already in there.
We've got three. Okay. Yes. Subway, of course, is moving over.
Okay.
The franchisee at Subway is the actual owner of the center, the Cold Stone Creamery, and then
Bubbaku.
Burrito.
And we're helping them identify two additional tenants
to
fill that center.
And he did say as well that the Bubbaku Burrito and Subway will both be the end units with outdoor patio space for both.
Oh, okay.
So the Subway will have outdoor seating.
Okay.
As well. Yeah.
So that outdoor space wouldn't be big enough if there was a restaurant you wanted to have a beer garden out there.
Excuse me. I'm hopeful that the Bubbaku Burrito, I haven't looked at their menu in other locations, but I don't know if anybody's reached out to us regarding the liquor license. So I would hope that if that's kind of their business model, that they might have that, and then you have that outdoor patio space.
Yeah.
I don't know. Any other questions for Michael? Thank you. Walter?
I don't have anything to add.
No? I had something I wanted to ask you. looking at it online, of course, and I don't think, so it's just the commercial that's listed here for September, I assume that's Burnt Barrel?
Yes.
Okay, so when I look at these numbers for year-to-date for construction value, once lot 17, which we permit issued in October, correct?
Mm-hmm.
What do you anticipate the year-to-date number value, construction value being?
I don't remember what the value was that they put down for lot 17.
Okay.
How much?
Yeah, I'm just looking, obviously I'm looking at it going, okay, well, we're $2 million behind where we were last year at this time, and I know we have more stuff going on, but just hopefully that catches us up a little bit. All right, anyone have any questions for Walter? No? All right, thank you. Tony?
Nothing additional.
Nothing additional for Mr. Tony Special. Does anybody have any questions?
Park Avenue, the street light, or stoplight?
Thing that we really could do to bring it back to IDOT, but at this time it's not believed that we will have a different number to really affect change. Yeah.
And with I think the last week the robots hadn't been back 100% yet. They were still doing some of the money schools, so we thought we were at a lower
questions for Tony? Hearing none, we don't have Matt, we don't have Chief. Does anybody have any questions based on their staff reports that you can ask Brent?
When moving day for Village Hall, there's something about construction being done.
Hopefully December 1 is what he's saying. They're waiting on doors.
Furniture and
stuff. I don't know about that. We're going to send Kumbaya.
So we'll be here in time. Yeah, I know. I believe our current computer consultant is planning on doing a weekend move over of IT equipment. So Alice and I were chatting earlier today, and maybe a case of ideally, you know, there'd be no interruption to service for residents, and maybe a case of, you know, kind of we do everything but the front desk, if you will, initially get set up over there where that person's maybe here one day and over there the next day while everybody else is. We believe if it's ready, we'll be ready to go. Tony told me Public Works has got the trailer ready to load up whatever stuff they're taking. So.
It's got the bucket.
What are you taking besides filing stuff?
What are we taking besides basically filing the computers? I think we're taking most of those with, but other than that.
Files and all
that
stuff.
Yeah, I understand some people went shopping the other day. Yeah, it worked out good that the, you know, the village does have a, you know, some credit cards that don't get a lot of use, but they do earn points, if you will, and Matt converted them to Amazon gift cards and used those during whatever that recent.
Yeah, but there's like Black Friday kind of Amazon sale.
So yeah, so he used that to, you know, the monitor for the conference room over there, you know, a microwave for the break room, I mean, things that we would do anyway.
Busy day yesterday. After the groundbreaking ceremony, we hustled over here and had our town center committee meeting, and we are very close. Our brochure should be in front of the board by, we said November, I put in my notes early November, but our goal is November 1st to have that ready for everybody to see and hopefully approve. Just waiting on a couple of things, I mean, small things, purchasing pictures, we're adding a map, and a couple of rewording things, but it looks fantastic. I'm biased, but I think it looks fantastic. I really think that we had Linda Knapp do, she did it. She did almost all, and she did an amazing job. So we got our money's worth on her, and then some. I attended the school board meeting last October 12th. Pretty neat to see they honored. They had postponed or suspended the award honors for during COVID, and so they honored quite a few students from elementaries. They were kindergartners all the way through high school students, and a lot of different types of art pieces, and it was just fantastic to get that back again. But and they didn't learn any of it from me. The other thing, the last thing, is that Principal Appreciation Week is this week, with Friday being Principal Appreciation Day. So even the homeschool principals should get a little pampering. And anything else you can get if you have children in school, maybe just a note or something nice. And that's all I got.
Excellent. Thank you.
Trustee.
Now
I got to
figure out who's the principal.
She's the principal.
She's a teacher.
She's the principal. You can be the board of trustees, the finance department, whatever. She's the principal.
He's the principal.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you. Trustee Lundy?
I also attended the Downtown Upcoming Meeting, and it was great to see what the final was going on that. Almost done. I'm still finished on there. For the library, Indoor Farmers Market, I believe the next one is November 12th. I know that they have up on the website that they need team volunteers needed, and they help restock books and such. You can go onto the website and get more information on that. The team needs some volunteer hours, especially. They're having a lot of activities going on for kids on Saturday, October 29th. A lot of fun stuff. Crafts and moving. And early voting is going to be at the library from October 24th to the 27th, and the October 31st to the 3rd. Also, Girl Scouts fall product is wrapping up on the 22nd. That will be geared up for cookie sales.
Good. Awesome. Thank you, Wendy. That's a lot. Trustee Shulmas.
Sugar Grove Park District, their meeting was on Columbus Day, Indigenous Peoples Day, whichever your preference may be. It was on October 10th. I couldn't make it. The agenda is on the website, but the important thing to know is that they are starting their sort of taxation budget cycle. So they started the meeting with the Truth and Taxation meeting, but I need to follow with Scott to see ultimately kind of how that went. Everything else on the agenda was kind of a continuation of what they had in the previous meeting. I bring up the issue with the taxation cycle because it came up again with the Forest Preserve Commission meeting. But I'll get to that in a little bit. They've got some surplus vehicles that they're getting ready to dispose of. I believe there's information there on their site itself in their clearing house. So there's like 7 trucks, tractors, that sort of stuff. So if anyone knows anyone, you get it back home. All right, so they did an overview, which came across very much as a warning regarding their tax levy. I know. And lots of sort of discussion points around inflationary impacts and that sort of stuff. So they've given a warning to the community that since it's going to be greater than 5%, they're going to do a truth in taxation hearing. They don't know exactly where it's going to be, where it's going to land yet, but they were clearly giving a heads up. So I say that here, you know, depending on your opinions of, you know, if people are going to call us and talk to us, there's you're going to get a chance. There's going to be several cycles of those discussions at public hearings, so I would absolutely. We've taken lots of steps. It's something I'm really proud of, guys, to be really frugal and appropriately frugal and cost sensitive. I know we've got some challenges coming up. I'm not, you know, ignorant of that. But I was surprised by that, for whatever it's worth. And then they ended the meeting by going into closed session to discuss potential litigation with Cook County. So it was an interesting meeting altogether to be a part of. Detailed agenda can be found on the website.
Thank you. Yeah, that for all involved and for us as well, we'll be talking about it, I believe. First meeting in November? What meeting are we in? Are we in the second one in October?
Yeah, the second meeting.
So our next meeting we'll be talking about ours as well. So it's gonna be a hard year. And I just don't know how people can afford it across the board. It's gonna be tough. So we'll have that discussion next meeting. President's report. Yes, I was at the town center meeting as well, and look forward to great progress and how that actually gets rolled out to not only the board but to the public. And then integrating with our website and Michael's use of it with developers. So, and I think we're taking a step farther in trying to do Q&A for folks that might have the questions that you can think of. So that's what we're trying to do now is kind of a Q&A and answer those that the committee and even this board gets their hands on them and kind of has the same messaging, you know. Holiday in the Grove, they're looking for volunteers too. So there's different shifts that they're going to have, like a 3-hour shift for those who remember those days are. It's really the 3rd of December. The 2nd should be a Friday, and that's kind of an extra evening, if you will, because that's a little light. So hopefully you guys can put that on your schedule, the lighting of the tree and the lighting of Main Street on the Friday around 5:15. So that's coming up. And then just on a separate note, I had a meeting with a home developer interested in property on the north side of town that does want to get in front of the board with their plan. I think they are tightening that up a little bit, make it a little bit prettier for presentation. But still interested. I think the hard part for that developer in particular is interest rates, and wanted to fast track it before, and now is kind of slowing down a little bit just based on the upfront cost to move our dirt. So, but still interested and still wants to pursue. It's just going to be interesting how quick they end up moving. But hopefully they are here before the end of the year for the village board to look at their kind of concept plan, if you will, and then hopefully they move to application after that. So keeping my fingers crossed that we can start getting some more residential going.
We only have 4 meetings left, right?
Yes.
You say before the end of the year.
Yes. Yeah. So that's all, but we do have a need to move to executive session this evening to discuss the collective bargaining agreement as well as personnel. So can I get a motion to move to executive session for the Open Meetings Act exception to discuss those two items?
So moved.
Can I get a second?
Second.
Thank you. I have a first out of Trustee Heron and a second out of Trustee Shomas. Roll call, please.
Trustee Heron?
Aye.
Trustee Shomas?
Aye.
Trustee White?
Aye.
Trustee Lundy?
Aye.
Trustee Bond?
Aye.
Thank you. Motion passed.